Hi everyone, this is Frank at Shooters Global, and today I've got a small tour of our mobile app for you. It has some features you've never seen in any available tools for shooters before. It'll make your practice much easier, whether you're an instructor, sportsman, or a regular shooter. Let's start by downloading it. It's called Drills, and it's available for both iOS and Android. The important note I want to make is that the Android app is still in beta at the time of shooting this video. It doesn't support building stages and challenges yet, but we're actively working on it. I highly suggest creating an account to store your statistics, stages, and trainings in the cloud, so when you reinstall the app or change your device, all data will be loaded automatically. We're also planning to have a web interface, so you'll be able to manage the statistics of yourself or your students on a big screen. When we have an account, let's connect our timer. Turn on the timer and go to Settings in the app, Bluetooth Devices. Your timer will appear here. Just tap on it and it will connect. You can also update the firmware here. We release updates quite often with improvements and new features, so be sure to keep your timer up to date for the best experience. Now to the actual features. Training allows you to practice dry fire. Tap this button to create a new one. Set the time required for an exercise, delay before the first rep, and pause between reps. You need to choose the gun type for the smart practice, since every firing mechanism sounds differently. Go to your training, select the number of reps, and start practicing. You'll get a signal for the start and the end of the exercise. Now, when things get exciting is when we switch to smart mode. The app will capture the sound of the trigger pull, so you get a clear readout of the time each rep took you to complete. Later, in statistics, you can analyze each of your practices and see the progress between reps. You can also record a video of your practice, which is especially useful with smart dry fire. First, hit record to start filming, and then start to start the timer. It will overlay your timings on the video, so you can analyze your each move or just share with friends. All videos are stored in your default gallery, but we're planning to add an in-app gallery so it doesn't get lost in your other videos. Let's move on to the stage shooting. This tool allows you to build, edit, walk, and share stages before you even build them in real life. Let's build our new stage first. You can select the size of the stage and set your starting point. Now, let's add some walls and obstacles. You can change their height and even add holes in them. Add some targets. Change the height of those as well, and even add a penalty target. Now, let's draw our penalty line and plan the route. When you're building a route, long press on its dot and set the targets you're planning to shoot from that spot. You can also change the height, which is useful when you're shooting through a window, for example. And there it is. You can preview your stage in 3D, walk the route the way you will when shooting, and even preview it in AR, which makes navigation much easier. But we took it a step further. You can even make a real size model of your stage and walk it like you would in real life. You can literally run the stage before wasting half an hour dragging the obstacles and targets across the range. How cool is that? You can also upload them so your friends or students can use them or use their own stages. Since the app is synced with the timer, all you need to do is hit start and go shoot. Once you finish, the app will ask you to mark your hits on each target and will calculate all the statistics you might need. You can also record a video, just like with dry fire. The app will overlay all shot time codes and stage settings. This is especially useful for influencers, instructors, and students who study remotely. Speaking of studying remotely, the app also has a social aspect, and a major piece of it is challenges. Challenges allow you to create group training. So let's imagine I'm an instructor. I take the stage that I created and I tap on Create a Challenge. Now I go to Community Challenges and find the one I just added. To activate it, I need to first complete it myself. Once it's done, other people can join the challenge. So I can have all my students' results in one place, including the video. We will soon be making it possible to share stages with a link and to create private challenges. Now let's take a quick look at free shooting. It pretty much speaks for itself. If you just need to record the shot quickly, you go here. It's also synced with the timer and you can record videos, but there is one more thing. You can see my timer is not connected, but the timer in the app still works. This is because the app can actually capture the shots too, using the microphone on your phone. It doesn't work nearly as good as a standalone timer because the sensitivity range is much lower on the phone. But in good conditions and small calibers, it actually works quite well. History is broken into dates with all your trainings inside the folder, and you can also review general stats on the home screen. That's pretty much it. Let us know what else you would like to see in the app in the comments and subscribe to us using the links below. All pre-orders will get a wireless charging magnetic holder for your timer for free. So if you haven't pre-ordered your timer yet, hurry up and go to our website. I'll leave a link for that too. Thanks so much for watching Shooters Global, and I'll see you next time.